Guru Nation, welcome to another episode in the car. Again, my buddy, my dog, Sonic, makes the vlog because we're waiting for my wife to get out of her appointment. But anyways, I got a question, and I think it's a good one, and I had some time because Sonic here is getting tired. So I got a question from somebody from DC who's working as a clinical research assistant. And let me read you the question. I have 2.5 years of experience as a CRC working on site. Can you please advise me on how to transition from a clinical research coordinator to a clinical research associate job where I could do monitoring visits? So basically, I actually get this question a lot. I know I've done video on it in the past, but I'll do one again on this topic. So basically what you do, without even realizing it, you probably do a fair amount of monitoring type of work as a CRC already. I know at my sites, we had all the CRCs cross-trained on each other's studies, and we had the CRCs serve as like mini monitors on site before the monitoring visit. One CRC would go look at the other CRC's books to make sure that they don't find anything major. And so we would be prepared. The idea was we'd be prepared before the monitor came. If you don't have this policy in place at your site and you have some autonomy there, some freedom to kind of freestyle and do things as you see fit, which I know a lot of sites offer. I know a lot don't as well, but if they do, most of them do, I would do this, even if it's not in your job responsibilities. This just goes to show you, just because something's not in your job responsibility does not mean it's not a good idea for you to do it. It doesn't mean it's not a good idea for you to learn new things, right? So I would say start doing some monitoring type work. Maybe do some SDR, source data review, on your coworkers, your fellow study coordinator study. And then you can add that skill to your resume and say, hey, you know, this is in addition to being a coordinator, I've also done source data review. Boom. Now you have an immediately transferable skill. Not only do you understand what research is, I think coordinators have one of the easiest transitions to becoming CRAs from any other position in research, because it's actually just as stressful to be a coordinator as it is to be a CRA, and you know a lot of the things already that a CRA needs to be doing. It's just a matter of looking at the other side of the equation as you're a CRA from a CRC. Now, another part of his question, hold on, Sonic. Sonic's moving the questions. Let me see what the question is. I have never had monitoring experience before. So guess what? If you do this, now you do, but make sure you update your CV. Now, here's another thing you should be doing. You're probably not doing the first thing. You can add regulatory. So I know at a lot of sites, especially the academic institutions, things are so streamlined that you are just doing one small task. If you're in a job like that, I would try to do more, even if you're not being asked to do it. Maybe just ask your supervisor, like, let's say you're not doing regulatory, but you wanna learn. Hey, I wanna shadow the regulatory person, please, so I could just add it to my resume, or I could be a backup, maybe, because nobody wants you to gain skills. Here's a secret, guys, all right? Nobody's gonna tell you. People don't wanna train you so that you can go do another job, all right? But that's not in your best interest. So you've got to make it to where if you're in one of these places, and I know a couple of sites, especially academic institutions, do this to where everything's so streamlined that you really have no function in real industry outside of that particular role. And obviously that's in the best interest of the employer. It's not in the best interest of you as a career professional. So I would ask your supervisors to find a way. If you feel like you won't get in trouble, then don't ask, just do it. If you feel like you might be getting in trouble, I would ask and give them a good rationale. Hey, I wanna learn regulatory because I'm actually truly interested in it, but also I wanna be able to be a backup in case this person's sick or you guys need a helping hand. I mean, let me know if that's a problem, but I would love to do that. try to do those kind of things to be as much of a generalist as you can, and don't forget to add it to your resume. Finally, if you're a coordinator, you probably, for 2.5 years, you've probably dealt with 5 to maybe 20 different CRAs, different monitors coming to your site. Are you adding them on LinkedIn? You need to add every single one of them on LinkedIn and every single one of their followers on LinkedIn, because networking is the name of the game. It's oftentimes not what you know, but who you know. I just did a podcast that got a lot of views and listens. Somebody had zero experience in research, zero experience in oncology, became a senior CRA just because their friend recommended them. Let that sink in for a second. No experience. Now, this person did lie on their resume too, so that had a lot to do with the fact that they got hired, but the first part's still true. They wouldn't have gotten the at-bats, the attempts, if they didn't get recommended. So if your CRAs really like your work, oftentimes these CRAs are encouraged, hey, go recruit colleagues for us. We would love to have your friends on board as CRAs. Network with your CRAs, talk to them, have private conversations. If you don't want it getting back to the PI or the site, tell them, hey, you'd appreciate it if they kept it confidential, but like, if they know anyone hiring at their company, they're interested, boom, you can send your CV to them. They can even give you more advice than I can do in this 7-minute video. So that's my recommendations to you. I would take that also, same strategy, and apply it to LinkedIn. And then when you add enough skills to your CV and you've done enough networking, it doesn't hurt, and you really think you're ready to make the move, it doesn't hurt to put your CV out there. Go to Indeed.com, boom, upload your CV. Go to ZipRecruiter.com, boom, upload your CV. Go to LinkedIn, boom, Career Builder, boom. I don't know if Glassdoor actually does this, but if they do, boom, you get the idea, right? Put your CV everywhere once you update your resume, because people are wanting you. People want CROs, and sponsors understand that CRCs know clinical research probably better than anybody else. The CRCs probably know clinical research better than CRAs because they understand the patient dynamics. CRAs, unless they've been coordinators, don't even have as generalist of an understanding. Trust me, a lot of our clients who want to open sites are CRAs. They lack a lot of practical common sense stuff that happens at the site that I know you as a CRC probably don't lack. So take this advice. Clinical research coordinator, clinical research assistant, take this advice, do with it what you may, but I would love to see if you can apply 2 or 3 of these strategies immediately and maybe even get a job in a few months. Maybe get multiple offers in a few months. So thank you very much for reaching out. Sonic finally fell asleep. Say bye-bye, Sonic. Bye-bye and good luck. And talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.